Education is the most powerful weapon which one can use to change the world. The words of Nelson Mandela describes education as a powerful weapon, and similarly many great leaders and philosophers have described education as a key element in the growth and development of a nation. In this unit today, we will discuss how media as an organization can help in educating the masses and promote growth and development of the nation. Let's start with the word education itself. The word educate comes from a Latin word educere, which means to lead out or bring out. Education is a process of bringing desirable changes into the behavior of the human being. It can also be defined as a process of imparting or acquiring knowledge or habits through instructions, discussions, or study. As perfectly explained by Aristotle, education as a creation of sound mind in a sound body, it develops man's faculty, especially his mind, so that he may be able to enjoy the contemplation of supreme truth, goodness and beauty. Education should be a means to empower children and adults alike to become active participants in the transformation of their societies. Education, therefore, has a crucial long-term role in developing knowledge and understanding of human rights, the value base and the skills required to strengthen a democratic culture. Now that we have clarity about education, let's talk about literacy and education. These terms are often interchangeably used but have a huge difference between the two. Literacy provides a person with the ability to acquire information to develop the know-how called education. In simple words, literacy is defined as acquiring the ability to read, write and understand. It is entirely concerned with the art of reading and writing, whereas education is defined as a systematic process of facilitating learning, receiving, experiencing, or acquiring knowledge, skills, values, and beliefs to impart instructions and provide an overall development. Education is a broader concept which takes into consideration the all-round development of a human personality, whereas literacy is a narrower concept that tends to maintain the status quo. Education plays a major role in smooth functioning of society as it helps individuals in broadening their mindset and provides value of unity which leads to integration in society. It helps in inculcating positive attitude amongst individuals as it creates awareness not only about issues but also our rights and duties of an individual. It helps in fostering and cherishing democratic qualities like liberty, equality, fraternity, justice, cooperative living, peaceful coexistence, respect to the dignity of individuals, sharing of responsibility, etc. These are essentials for the development of a nation and progress of the society. Education means innovation, and innovation and creativity can only occur when people are skilled enough to know how to operate with different technologies. Education is one of the most important components in advancing human development. HDI, which is a composite of index assessing progress, talks about three dimensions, out of which one is knowledge, which talks about knowledge measured by years of education. Human development reports have annually explored critical development themes through the HD lens and have reinforced the importance of investing in the education development. Literacy is considered to be a key for overall development of individuals, boost economic growth by enhancing skills and livelihoods of people, and improve people's life and nation's overall development. It is very important to understand our present education system by incorporating sustainable change to match with global standards. When studying about education and media, it becomes important for us to connect it with historical overview of education. The ancient Vedic period was based on Gurukul system, where gurus were the central figure of education system. The students had to leave their houses and stay at Gurukuls with fellow students and the teacher. Here, the main focus on the holistic development of students by not only making them socially aware, but also building their personalities and character, imbibing self-control and discipline, and nurturing their intellectual, spiritual and physical development. With the Britishers coming in, they brought with them Western education. They focused on spreading education in India, not to produce thinking intellectual minds, but to produce clerks for the administrative machinery. This new Western culture and education gave birth to a new awakening as well. Several Western educated social thinkers contributed in rousing the national consciousness in the minds of the Indians in the 19th and the 20th centuries. The post-independence era focused to secure justice, liberty and equality for all citizens to achieve these noble goals of education. Since independence, India has made substantial progress in the field of education. In 2011, 75% of the population was literate. However, Indian education still lags on many fronts compared to developed nations and have succinctly summed up in NCHIO Pratham report, which observed that it encourages rote learning rather than comprehension. Test scores take precedence over open debates and logical reasoning, and very little room is left for creativity. But I would like to end this historical overview on a positive note. With the advent of technology, we have all-time high hopes. Technology is offering new possibilities and making life easier for both students and educators. It is addressing the challenges of delivering education in remote areas. Online learning is also a cost-effective and faster mode of learning. Concept of communication is closely linked to learning. Education, hence, is essentially a communication process where the communicator and the receiver, that is, teacher or a student, take part in two-way exchange for the growth and development of the student. Internet has been used to expand access, promote efficiency, improve quality of teaching and learning. It also provides educational opportunities to scattered and rural populations, ethnic minorities, girls and women, persons with disabilities and the elderly people. A feature of media technologies is the flexibility and adaptability. It allows us to access knowledge, databases and find information in multiple forms like audio, text, video, image, etc. Information can be accessed anytime and anywhere. It has the ability to transcend time and space. Furthermore, distance education serves to reverse social dynamics by bringing school to students rather than students to school. Information technology has made education accessible also in remote areas and to geographically dispersed learners. However, people, especially in rural areas, may face challenges in three stages. Learning about computers and the internet, learning with computers and the internet, learning through computers and the internet. It is quite clear now that when used appropriately, different ICTs can serve as a great tool for expanding scope and access of education. These are some of the initiatives which was taken by our government for education using ICT. Very briefly, one by one, let's have a look on them. SITE, Satellite Instruction Television Experiment, was the first attempt to use technology as an educational tool. TVs were set for community viewing in schools or panchayat centers. It aimed at creating a positive attitude to formal education and making education interesting, creative, purposive and stimulating. Kheda Communication Project was another great experiment done in Kheda district of Gujarat using television. Villagers were encouraged to participate as actors, writers in the production of TV programs which was based on the community issues such as alcoholism, family planning, etc. It acted as a medium to initiate a dialogue among locals. Jhabua, a predominantly rural area with a large tribal population in the state of Madhya Pradesh, was experimented with satellite dish, TV sets, VCRs and other equipment installed in several villages, which received television broadcasts for 2 hours every evening. In Hole in the Wall project, a computer was placed in the kiosk on a wall in a slum and children were allowed to use it freely. The experiment was conducted with the purpose to demonstrate how technology can be used to teach children without formal training. Gyandut Samiti established 32 kiosks at the high schools and higher secondary schools to provide them with the local educational contents through the server. At present, the Samiti provides the following facilities like career guidance, syllabus, interaction with other schools, moral stories, biographies, etc. Vidya Vahini program aimed at connecting 60,000 government-aided schools through internet and intranet. And E-Pathshala, a joint initiative of Ministry of HRD and NCERT, provides educational resources for students, teachers as well as parents. UGC, in collaboration with INSAT, launched Educational Television Project, popularly known as countrywide classroom. Media centers were established in 6 universities of India for the quality enrichment of higher education. UGC InfoNet program is another initiative by UGC which aims at modernizing the university campuses with the state-of-the-art campus-wide networks and setting up its own nationwide communication network named UGC InfoNet. Gyan Darshan and Gyan Vani are TV and radio channels which aim to enhance and supplement the teaching-learning process through live sessions. Students can interact through telephone, email or through chat mode on Gyandhara. Gyandhara is an internet audio counseling service offered by IGNU. eGyankosh is a national digital repository to store, index, preserve, distribute and share the digital learning resources developed by the open and distance learning institutions. And like these, there are many experiments done so far. Some experiments fail, some succeed, but the strive for education continues. And it will continue till we develop mechanisms to deliver quality education to the last deprived person. That's all for this unit. This unit attempts to explain how important the education is and how media can serve as a catalyst by supplementing its efforts with the efforts of government and society. Thank you.